Donald Trump marching toward the GOP nomination. Republicans, once bent on defeating him, are now having to reassess their efforts to stop him.
Our next guest says there's something the Never Trump conservatives aren't seeing in Trump that makes him the one to really rally behind. Joining us now with her take is Fox News contributor Stacey Dash. Good morning. Thanks for being
Good
with
morning.
Us.
Good morning.
So what are the things about Donald Trump that you like that conservatives are not seeing?
Well, I think what they're not seeing, it's not what they're not seeing, it's what they are seeing. And what they are seeing is that he knows both sides of the game. And he is absolutely anti-establishment. You know, he's for the people. And, you know, they're saying he's not conservative, and which is not true. He's for strong military, lower taxes, you know, fair trade, immigration. These are all things that are conservative. So I don't understand why they're not behind him, other than the reason that he will not be their puppet.
Mitt Romney yesterday on the campaign trail says he's not endorsing Ted Cruz, but he was campaigning with him in Utah and in an effort to try to steal some delegates away from Donald Trump. He says Donald Trump is vulgar, he's a bigot, and he doesn't represent the heart of the Republican Party.
I think he does represent the heart of the Republican Party, and that's what scares them. You know, but he will not be a puppet. And it surprises me, Mitt Romney doing that, because I went to an event for Mitt Romney when he was running for president, and Trump supported him 100%. And so for him to do this is like a stab in the back.
Some are saying perhaps Mitt Romney would like to be the nominee himself, and
maybe
if there's a contested convention, he'll be drafted, or he believes he might be.
Well,
what
he
do
has
you think
chance.
The Republican grassroots, actual Republican voters, would do if the man with the most delegates doesn't end up becoming the nominee?
I think they'll be very angry. And they might, you know, who knows? You know, the people are very angry right now. And if we don't listen to the people, you know, the Republican Party is a party. A party is made up of people. That means we must listen to the people. And if we don't, they're going to be angry. And there might be, you know, repercussions from it.
Let's fast forward to November and say Donald Trump is the nominee.
Yes.
What does he need to do to get women support and minority support?
I think he has to have an outreach program, which I have a very strategic one. I have national security advisors that use a comprehensive strategy around the world that would work domestically. And I've gotten in touch with very prominent minority leaders like Mr. Kane. And he said he would be on board.
Herman Cain?
Yes, Herman Cain.
So Herman Cain would support Donald Trump or
would
work
support,
on his behalf?
Yes, and this minority outreach for whatever candidate it is, you know, because that's what's most important.
What about
to win,
what about
for us to win,
for
the
women,
Republican Party?
On the strategic front for women, the minority question, Herman Cain, but he's really high unfavorable numbers right now. He and Hillary Clinton, I think, are the two potential candidates who have the highest unfavorable ratings among women and minorities in a, like forever.
Right.
So what do you do to capture the women vote?
I have no idea. I don't know. I don't understand why women would be against him. I mean, he wants to improve the economy. He wants to, you know, lower taxes. He wants to have a strong military. He wants to do all the things that conservatives want. So I don't understand why women would be against him. I can see minorities. I could see him needing to reach out to minorities more, but he did put Dr. Ben Carson in charge of his education program, which is a huge deal.
So the claim, you haven't seen a lot of Trump opponents argue against his immigration positions in any detail. You know, they haven't argued explicitly for open borders. They have instead called him a racist. He's a bigot. He's a hater. A lot of Republicans have said this. Mitt Romney has, in effect, said it. Do you think that's true?
No. And it baffles me how people who are here illegally have now become the victim. They're not following the law, but they're the victims.
Seems like everybody who is a Trump supporter likes that he's tough talk, right?
Yes.
Tough talk in Trump. But even his wife, Melania, in an interview with Greta Van Susteren, said sometimes he needs to tone down the rhetoric. Sometimes I don't like the language. Do you think that hurts him with women?
I don't know. I don't think it hurts him. Not with all women. I mean, for me, I like the strong talk. I like that he says what he means and means what he says. He's from New York. You know, he's a New Yorker. It's just the way we are. It's more like street. He's street. And no matter what socioeconomic position you have in the city, you have that culture in you if you come from New York. It's just part of who you
are. I like
the
way you pronounce New York, like a New Yorker.
Yeah.
Stacey, great to see you this morning.
Thank you.